गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ अभिषेक शर्मा फ्रॉम माउंट लिटराजी स्कूल झांसी। स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग द सेवन चैप्टर ऑफ बिजनेस स्टडीज, दैट इज सोर्सेज ऑफ बिजनेस फाइनेंस। एंड इन माई प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट GDR, दैट इज ग्लोबल डिपॉजिटरी रिसिप्ट। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस ADR, IDR एंड फीचर्स ऑफ ट्रेड क्रेडिट। सो स्टार्टिंग विद ADR, and ADR is just like a GDR except that it can be issued to a citizen of USA only and it can be listed in the US stock exchange. Shares listed by the companies are held by an international bank called depository, which receives dividend notices and report. ADRs are subjected to much stricter disclosure requirement than GDRs because regulation of US stock exchange are very strict. Annual legal and accounting cost of maintaining an ADR are much higher than GDR. IDR. An IDR is also like GDR except that it is issued to citizen of India. Through IDR, foreign companies raise funds from Indian market. The foreign company's IDR will deposit shares to an Indian depository. The depository issues receipt to investor in India against these shares. Standard Chartered Bank was the first global company to file for an issue of IDR in India. Now, trade credit. So, students, trade credit refers to an arrangement whereby a manufacturer is granted credit from the supplier of raw material, inputs, spare parts. The supplier allows their customer to pay their outstanding balance within the credit period. Generally, the duration of credit is 3 to 6 months. Once again, I repeat, generally the duration of credit or merchantile credit is 3 to 6 months, and thus it is a short-term financing facility. The availability of trade credit depends upon the nature, size, and status of the firm. Now let's study the features of trade credit. Readily available. Trade credit is available without any special efforts on the part of the manufacturer or trader or merchant. This means it is easily available. Flexible. There are no rigid, hard and fast rules and regulation involved in trade credit. It can be easily adjusted with the changing needs of purchase as time of payment is generally adjusted in view of past dealings. No flotation cost. No flotation cost is involved in arranging the trade credit. This means you are not allowed to spend surplus money for arranging the loan from other institution. And trade credit can be easily available without having any flotation cost. Increase in price. Sometimes the supplier may increase the price of commodity or raw material supplied if he is selling goods on credit. And last is legal action. In trade credit, the buyers generally issue a promissory note, and in case if he fails to meet this commitment, the supplier can take a legal action against it. So once again, I am going to recall trade credit. Trade credit is basically a tool for short-term finance, and it refers to the arrangement whereby a manufacturer granted credit from the supplier of raw material, inputs, spare parts. The supplier allows their customer to pay their outstanding balance within a credit period. Generally, the duration of credit is 3 to 6 months, and thus it is a short-term financing facility. It depends upon the nature of the firm, size of the firm, and status of the firm. And the features which a trade credit possesses is readily and easily available. This is very flexible system. There are no rigid rules and regulation involved in the trade credit. No flotation cost. Increases in price. Sometimes the supplier may increase the price of the commodity or raw material supplied if he or she is selling goods on credit basis rather than cash basis. And last is legal action. In trade credit, the buyer generally issue a promissory note, and in case he fails to meet his commitment, the supplier can take legal action against him. So that's all for today. थैंक यू एंड हैव अ नाइस डे।